Hi friends, welcome to another episode of RNN Blog. So today we will be reviewing one of the most popular eateries in Kolkata. It is Koshe Kosha Jadavpur branch. We have ordered a non-veg meal from there, a non-veg thali. So we will be reviewing each and every food over there. So be with us. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, don't waste your time. Just subscribe it now and like, comment and share. Your comments will be extremely helpful to us to improve. So let's eat. So friends, we have ordered a non-veg mutton thali. So let us introduce what they have given in this. So first of all, as you can see, this is shukto. So shukto is a plethora of vegetables cooked in the most unique spices with creamy milky gravy with slightest hint of sweetness and a core taste of bitterness. To the next item, it is shona muger dal with korai shuti, or the lentil dish in thick consistency cooked with green peas. To the next of it is the mochar ghonto. Mochar ghonto is an unique Bengal delicacy with a hint of Bengali spices, taking the dish to the next level. To the next, we are having fish curry. That is Rui Kalia, a large sized Rui or Katla fish cooked in subtle and fiery spices, and it is a good accompaniment to rice and pulao. It is a traditional Bengali dish for each house. We are having the mutton kosha. It is a slow cooked mutton with variety of Bengali spices including garam masala. The use of desi ghee makes it fragrant. The slow cooking and the fried onions used imparts black color to it. On the bhaji, we are having papad, the masala papad, the crispy aloo bhaja or the potato fry. We are having begun bhaja or eggplant fry, some onion salad, and last but not the least is chutney, which is pineapple or papaya chutney, which they have offered. Now for the mains, they have given the option of providing rice as the item, main item. Along with it, one can take either roti or pulao. So we have taken the pulao, which is a sweet rice preparation with lots of cashew and resin. And to end the meal on a sweet note, they have given us a baked rasagulla. So altogether, this costs around 495 rupees. We ordered it through Uber Eats, so we got 346 plus the delivery and the taxes amounts to 380. This food is more than adequate for a person, and you can definitely have a order for this food if you want to enjoy the comfort of a thali at your home. So friends, if you like this video, do subscribe to our channel. Like, share and comment with your friend. Your comment will be extremely helpful to us. Thank you for watching.